Hello, I'm Julie Tall. I'm one of the doctors at Parsley Health. We're here in the New York Center, and today I'm here to talk about autophagy. So we get asked all the time about healthy aging and longevity. So today we want to talk about one of the cellular processes that's necessary for healthy aging and how you can make sure you're doing what you can to stoke that process. The thing we're talking about is called autophagy. So what is autophagy? To keep it simple, autophagy is the housekeeping of the cells. In the journal Nutrients, it's defined as aiding in the lysosomal degradation and removal of old and unwanted cellular molecules, including proteins, ribosomes, lipid droplets, and other organelles. In short, it's how our body recycles damaged proteins and organelles. Organelles are like the organs of our cells. And this happens naturally all the time, but certain lifestyle factors can influence how well it performs, and we'll get into this later. Let's start with, why is this important? When your cells undergo autophagy, they take a break from dividing, which is a good thing. Too much cell dividing leads to the formation of free radicals, and that leads to cellular damage and disease. A good analogy is kind of like eating leftovers. Without eating the food you've already made that's sitting in your fridge, the fridge will overflow and the food will go bad. So we need to eat those leftovers so that we can continue replenishing with healthy cells. But there are many benefits to autophagy. First, it can limit inflammation by influencing the development, homeostasis, and survival of inflammatory cells. Damaged cells can trigger inflammatory pathways. Some studies indicate that autophagy can play a therapeutic role in the development of inflammatory diseases, including Crohn's disease, cystic fibrosis, and pulmonary hypertension. Autophagy is known to boost immunity by clearing pathogens, introducing healthy cells. It also has the potential for cancer prevention. Early studies have shown, at least in some cases, oncogenesis, or the formation of cancer cells, proceeds when there's a temporary inhibition of autophagy, and this is due to the ability that autophagy can remove cancerous cells. It also helps with aging. Autophagy creates younger cells, and we lose this process as we age. So proteins and debris start to build up, and this has been linked to diseases like Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, and other memory and movement disorders. It's been found to prevent many other diseases besides neurodegeneration. For instance, cardiomyopathy, diabetes, liver disease, autoimmune disease, and infection. So how do we induce autophagy? Well, we'll start with sleep. Studies have shown that REM sleep can stimulate autophagy. It maintains neuronal integrity and housekeeping functions of the brain by modulating noradrenaline levels. So to stimulate, do your best to get 7 to 8 hours of quality sleep at night. So let's talk about exercise and autophagy. Autophagy is an evolutionary adaptation designed to help humans survive things like famine, intense exercise, extreme heat and cold. Since we live pretty comfortably today, any form of healthy stress helps to stimulate this process. To stimulate, high-intensity interval training workouts are great for inducing this healthy stress. You can also try infrared sauna or cryotherapy. Next, healthy diet. Your body needs energy to repair itself. Gluten, dairy, and processed foods can contribute to lack of autophagy. To stimulate, fill your diet with real whole foods, especially fat, which is suspected to stimulate autophagy instead of protein and carbs. This is why you often hear about the keto diet supporting autophagy. If you're looking to supplement a diet of whole and healthy foods to further stimulate autophagy, studies have found green tea and hesperidin are effective in stimulating this process. Next, limiting chronic stress. Though healthy stress is good for autophagy, unhealthy stress occurring consistently over time can prevent your body from cleaning house and taking care of those old and dead proteins. To stimulate, try to limit this type of stress by 1. Finding movement and joy, 2. Adopting a meditation practice. Even just 5 or 10 minutes a day can be very helpful. And 3. Fostering a sense of community. That is, spending time with your friends and family, joining a group in your area, anything that fosters a sense of community. Another thing that's being studied a lot for stimulating autophagy, especially in Alzheimer's patients, is intermittent fasting. Constantly feeding your body prevents autophagy. Fasting stimulates a pathway called AMPK, which inhibits mTOR activity. mTOR activity is the pathway in the body that tells cells to divide and grow. It's activated when you're well fed. Basically, you have to inhibit mTOR activity in order to stimulate autophagy. When you fast, it tells the body to stop dividing your cells and instead eat up this debris you've already made. To stimulate, try starting with a 12-hour fasting window between dinner and breakfast, and talk to your doctor to see if a longer fasting window could be appropriate for you. In reality, autophagy isn't something most people need to be thinking about all the time. The best way to ensure this process is performing smoothly is to focus on your everyday lifestyle choices. Make sure you're getting quality sleep, eating healthy whole foods, and moving your body, and the rest should fall into place.